Do you want to learn how to catch house sparrows with a repeating elevator trap? Let's learn how.
Hi, it's Jeff with Backyard Birds. I'm going to show you how to use this sparrow trap combined with this shelter box to catch house sparrows.
On the right is the repeating elevator trap. Sparrows enter to get bait, land on the elevator which lowers, and the birds enter the holding cage through a trap door. On the left is the shelter box. Sparrows in the holding cage enter it through a hole in the box. The trap combined with the shelter box can be used to trap house sparrows year round. I've been trapping house sparrows for many years. Since I started using the shelter box with the elevator trap, the number of sparrows I've caught has increased dramatically. From 4 in 2017 to 95 in 2018. These house sparrows were caught in one day. If you like nature how-to videos, think about subscribing to my channel by clicking on the red subscribe button below the video. So what is a house sparrow and why would you want to trap them? Let me explain. This is a male house sparrow that has taken over this bluebird nest box. The house sparrow, also known as the English sparrow, is an invasive introduced species in North America and elsewhere. It is an extremely aggressive bird that outcompetes native cavity nesting birds and will destroy their eggs, young, and even adults in order to use a nesting cavity or to eliminate nesting competition. They are not a protected species in North America and can be legally trapped and eliminated. For more information on house sparrows and their invasive nature, click on the link at the top of this video.
Let's talk about the equipment we need to trap house sparrows. We need a repeating elevator trap like this one, which is the deluxe repeating sparrow trap. And we need an enclosed wooden box that the sparrows can use for shelter. This is the repeating sparrow trap that I purchased. The bait compartment is filled with white millet. When a bird hops on the elevator arm, it lowers and the bird exits through a hole. The birds are trapped in the holding compartment. Here's how it all works. A bird lands on the entrance platform and hops on the elevator arm as it tries to get to the bait. The arm lowers and the bird enters the holding chamber through a hole with a trap door. The arm rises back up, ready to trap another bird. A trap door over the hole prevents birds from escaping. This model is the Deluxe Repeating Sparrow Trap and is available from sparrowtraps.net. You can find a link to it in the video description. This is the shelter box that I built. It attaches to the sparrow trap. On one end is a viewing door so you can look into the box. Hardware cloth covers the entrance to prevent the birds from escaping. On the other end is a clean-out door, and it can be used to remove litter from the box. An L-screw is used to keep the clean-out door closed. The door is only used if there are no sparrows in the box. As you can see, the shelter box has a hole where the birds enter. It is all wood, constructed of 1-inch white pine, which insulates the birds from extreme cold and heat. Both doors are recessed on the ends to prevent rain from entering the box. I've also added knobs to each door to make them easier to open and close. You can find a link to purchase one of my shelter boxes in the video description. Before attaching the box to the trap, cut a hole in the holding chamber that lines up with the hole of the shelter box. Attach the shelter box to the trap with 2 screws on each side of the box. This is the shelter box attached to the trap. Because there is no handle, the trap and box combo is awkward to lift and move. But that can be remedied by adding a board with a handle to the top of the trap. The board is attached to the trap with 2 screws on each end. The handle is located in the center of gravity to make for easier lifting of the trap and box combo. 1/4-inch hardware cloth is attached to the board with pan head screws. White millet can be sprinkled on the hardware cloth with no worry of it blowing away. An added benefit of the board is it acts as a roof over the holding chamber. You can place food under the board to keep it dry. I've made some other modifications to the trap. 1/4-inch hardware cloth is attached to the entry platform with pan head screws to keep millet from blowing away. A knob and hook have been added to the access door to make it easier to open and close. The rubber flap you see keeps birds from escaping when the door is open. Let me demo the trap catching a bird. A sparrow lands on the entrance platform to enter the bait chamber. The rest of this demo is shot using previously trapped birds like this male house sparrow. When the sparrow hops on the elevator, the bird's weight lowers the elevator arm.
The bird sees a hole to the holding chamber and exits the elevator through the trap door. The bird heads straight for the shelter box for safety. Upon exiting the elevator, the arm rises and the trap is ready to catch another bird.
Let's look at the shelter box in action. These house sparrows have been caught using the elevator trap. Watch as these birds come and go from the shelter box. The birds will enter the box to escape predators, but they also use it during inclement weather, and at night they use it as a roost.
Let me explain why the addition of the shelter box makes the elevator trap so successful at catching house sparrows. To successfully catch house sparrows in a repeating trap, it's critical to have live decoys in the trap. House sparrows are social birds, and the decoy birds attract more house sparrows. Watch as this house sparrow wants in with the other house sparrows in the trap. The problem with most repeating sparrow traps is the decoy birds suffer from stress and die.
The birds need shelter from predators and the weather, as well as a place to roost at night. By using a shelter box with a baited trap, the trap birds will remain healthy and in turn attract more house sparrows.
To keep the decoy sparrows alive and well, they need food and water. Tuna fish cans work great for serving both. I recommend feeding cracked corn in one can and white millet in another. Water should be placed in a can as well. Place the cans of food and water in the trap through the access door. Clip one wing of your decoy birds to distinguish them from freshly caught birds. An added benefit to clipping wings is the birds can't fly away if they accidentally escape.
Now that we've covered the elevator trap, the shelter box, and the decoy birds, let me explain how to use all three to catch house sparrows effectively. First, choose a location where house sparrows congregate. This may be a feeding station or near cover. This will be your trapping location. Every day, scatter white millet on the ground in the trapping area. Place the trap and box in the same area. You can place it on the ground or on a table. It's much easier to remove trap birds if it's on a table. Furthermore, you will catch fewer non-target birds if the trap is off the ground. Once the trap is in place, put white millet in the bait compartment. Also sprinkle it on the entrance platform and on top of the trap. Continue to sprinkle millet on the trap daily so the birds get used to feeding on it. You may need to do this multiple times a day. Once the birds are accustomed to feeding near the trap and on the trap, it's time to reduce the amount of millet you are feeding. Continue to place a little millet on the trap, but stop sprinkling millet on the ground in the area. Do not feed millet anywhere else. The only source of millet should be on the trap. If there is millet elsewhere, the house sparrows are unlikely to enter the trap to get at the bait. By using an elevator trap, shelter box, and decoy birds, you will be successful at catching house sparrows. Let's talk about the best season for trapping house sparrows with this trap. From my experience, fall, winter, and spring are the best seasons for trapping. In Topeka, I've caught house sparrows in elevator traps from September through April. Once they start nesting, I start using nest box traps.
Once nesting season ends, I quit trapping until fall.
Once you start catching birds, you will need to remove some from the trap and shelter box. Flush the sparrows from the box by opening the viewing door. Slide an object like this wall scraper between the box and the trap. The sparrows are now trapped outside of the shelter box, and you can reach in through the access door to remove them. Never remove all the sparrows from the trap. I try to keep at least 5 sparrows as decoys to attract more sparrows. I recommend keeping a mix of male and female house sparrows as decoys, with the majority of the decoys being males. After removing some birds, remove the wall scraper so the birds can enter the shelter box. When operating the trap, there are a few rules you need to follow. Monitor the trap regularly. Check it at least a few times a day, as the trap may catch native birds as well as house sparrows. If any native bird is captured, it should be released immediately. To release a native bird, chase the sparrows into the shelter box and cover the hole. Open the access door, hold open the door flap, and let the bird fly out through the door. In Topeka, I've often caught northern cardinals, dark-eyed juncos, and American tree sparrows, but I've also caught white-throated sparrows and Harris sparrows. If you can't monitor for a period of time, use a twist tie to wire open the elevator. An added benefit is the sparrows can feed freely in the bait compartment, making them easier to trap later. Be careful when removing house sparrows from the trap so they don't escape. Beware, they will bite you when you grab them. This is what I sound like when bitten. Ouch! Don't be surprised if you say something worse. Keep your decoy birds well fed and watered. Be sure to check their food and water twice a day. Don't release house sparrows somewhere else, as that just moves the problem. Instead, they should be humanely euthanized. There is a link in the description to learn more about euthanizing house sparrows. Let's talk about my trapping results. Since I started trapping house sparrows in 2012, I've caught over 200 house sparrows with my elevator trap. In 2018, I added a shelter box to my trap. In less than a year, I've caught over 100 sparrows using the trap with a shelter box. From my experience, it is by far the most efficient way to trap house sparrows. During the breeding season, I also use nest box traps to catch house sparrows. Learn more about them by following the link at the top of the video. With the reduction in the number of house sparrows, I'm seeing more native birds at my feeders in the winter. During the breeding season, the bluebirds and great crested flycatchers are now successful at nesting and raising their young. Before I started trapping, the house sparrows destroyed their nests.
Using the information you just learned, you should be successful at catching house sparrows where you live. You can find links to the trap and box in the video description. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it, and leave a comment. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below the video. For more how-to videos like this one, consider subscribing to my channel. Be sure to click the bell widget to be notified of new videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on the Backyard Birds channel.